background is as a private sector first strategy consultant and then as an industrial individual, so Shell and then McKinsey for both about 5 to 6 years. And I work in this space now because it really helps my clients think about how they make decisions differently. It's exciting, it really challenges the way they innovate. And as a result, I just think it's a great tool for education, particularly in the social sector space, which is what brought me to working on it with Amani.
So, over a decade of working in social entrepreneurship, I almost never saw us looking to nature for solutions or for answers. And it just struck me that if we were trying to rethink how education needs to happen, how do we better prepare change makers, then trying to find 21st century ways or in fact even ancient ways that we've lost touch with seems to be a good place to start. We designed Bio-Empathy as the starting place of this program, partly as a way to help people kind of step into a new reality, peel back the layers of the self and come into the program with an open mind, but also because we genuinely think that there are answers to social innovation or to social challenges that nature can provide a direction or a clue towards finding.
I look back at all of that time and I think in a lot of the consulting work, we never used nature as a source of inspiration or innovation. There was no reflection on, could biomimicry help us? Are there species which are doing this in a way that would be truly insightful for us to learn from?
So at the Amani Institute Bio-Empathy course, what we do is look at two elements of what we call bio-empathy. The first is seeing nature as a mentor, so, along the lines of biomimicry and what the Bio-Mimicry Institute puts forward as the six principles of life.
It's really looking to nature as a guide, as a teacher, as a source of what can we emulate, what can we mimic, how can we copy its perfection at doing so many things which are exactly the direction we'd like to take it as a species.
The second is nature as mirror, reconnecting with nature in order to understand better the way nature operates and then use that as a source of inspiration for coming up with new ideas. So the two are intimately linked, and we have to do both at the same time in order to see nature as a way to come up with solutions for the problems that we face.
In order to do that, we need to reconnect as individuals back to really our own souls and being part of nature. Because to emulate, you need to be quiet and you need to be able to listen. And listening is at the core of what we do in terms of our reconnection work, which has a lot of different influences from Taoism to Native American practices to just working with an individual's own beliefs and religious systems. But what's wonderful about nature is it tends to work for everyone.